Hello, it is William calling from Wee Wee Blogs. A lot of you guys are very excited about the hashtag Eurovision Again non-qualifier special, where fans pick their favorite non-qualifier that did not make the final of Eurovision. In recent weeks, Wee Wee Blogger Robin has been running a series of polls. We asked you first to decide what was your favorite non-qualifier from each country. Then we asked you to vote in a mega poll, combined the winner, the best non-qualifier from each country. And now we've had a poll, 15,000 of you have voted, or rather we got 15,000 votes, and now we can reveal the top 10 non-qualifiers in the history of Eurovision according to our readers. Are you guys ready? Let's do this! In 10th place with our readers, San Marino 2013, Valentina Minetta, Chrysalide. My goodness, singing about a butterfly, being reborn, holding that gorgeous IKEA lamp. This was a huge fan favorite. She put the bebop girl from Baku in her past, and she moved forward as a true performer. This is my favorite of all her Eurovision performances. In 9th place, according to our readers, it's Estonia, Koit and Laura with Verona. Now at Eurovision 2017, they did get lost in Verona, and sadly they finished in 14th place. This song was amazing. Yes, it was a little dated, but it was very catchy. I thought the staging was fabulous, that digital runway. Koit's expressions, very memeable, but Laura was beautiful. I guess the two of them don't have the most obvious chemistry, but they're both amazing performers, and I was convinced this was gonna go through. 8th place among our readers, also from Eurovision 2017, Jana Burcheska, Dance Alone. There was so much hype for this performance. The video is beautiful. A woman who is kind of a bit older, looking back at her past. It was very emotional. Jana is an amazing performer. She's great presence. Sadly, there was no staging, and that's what was her undoing. But this song, this is a track for the ages. 7th place among our readers, Portugal 2019, Conan Osiris. Of course, is a former sex shop worker, very creative, very inventive. This was the avant-garde. It was always gonna sink or swim, and sadly it sank. It finished 15th out of 17 countries. You know, he's a great interviewee. Watch all the interviews with him. He is so funny, so present. This was perhaps too futuristic, or kind of, what's the word? This was too avant-garde. I think maybe it just alienated a lot of people because it wasn't that sort of mainstream pop. He was swerving in his own direction and it just veered a little too far, but I love it. Love it, hope he comes back. 6th place among our readers, Bulgaria 2011, Polygenova, Nainat. Ganova was amazing. This was her first attempt at Eurovision. She came in 12th place, somehow behind Witloof Bay from Belgium. I don't get that. She is amazing. This was very rock. This was the rock-edged, you know, hard side of Polly. Later, when she came back with a dance banger, I think it suited her better. But this just really announced her presence in the Eurovision sphere. Love her. 5th place among our readers, Israel 2014, May Feingold, Same Heart. Now y'all, this came next to last. Yes, 14th out of 15th, ahead of only Georgia, The Shit in Morocco. This is madness. I think the problem was staging. The song was amazing, it was really catchy, it was very powerful, Emancipated Woman. But sadly, Israel didn't do much with the stage. They gave her two dancers who just kind of sashayed back and forth. And then she was wearing like a dark outfit, and at times she blended into the floor. It was like really a case of the stage swallowing the singer, and that's unfortunate. She could have just, you know, stood on a box with some like fake walls, just focused on her, she would have killed it. She's an amazing performer. I was shocked by how low this result was. One of my favorite tracks from Eurovision ever. Fourth place from Eurovision 2010, it is Slovakia's Kristina Pekalova, Pelakova rather, Hora Roni. Y'all, she was serving Mother Earth Ferngully realness. This was so cool. People loved this ahead of Eurovision, but then on the Eurovision stage, she was very nervous. She had very strong dancers to support her. You know, they were covered in vines and leaves and all sorts of shrubs and bushes, all sorts. But sadly, she was just really nervous. I still think this should have gone through. She actually placed, ouch, she placed 16th out of 17th. That is really cruel. I remember watching her performance and we were like, oh, she's gonna go through. Let's place a bet. She didn't qualify and I lost the money. So I have stopped gambling. But no, this is an amazing song. I still listen to this sometimes. I still watch the music video. She slays. Third place, we head to Eurovision 2018 and Switzerland, Zibs. My girl Coco took it to the next level. I wasn't a huge fan of the studio cut, but when you see her live on that big stage, her and her brother threw it down. I love that kind of pyro gun exploder thing she had where she was shooting sparks into the sky. She can perform. She really, really owned the Lisbon Arena. It was unbelievable. She came 13th, sadly. The duo came 13th. Very unlucky for them. This was one of the biggest growers of the Eurovision season, I thought. Second place among our readers, we go back to Eurovision 2017. It is Finland's Norma John with Blackbird. You sang when my heart sang, now you remind me of something I'll never have, so Blackbird, don't sing. This breaks my heart. They came 12th in their semifinal, 12th of 18th. They were like among my favorites of the whole year. So classy, so emotional. I think part of the problem was that they were in the first half of the semifinal, I believe, alongside or not far from Salvador Sobral. And you know, two magical ballads, and this battle of two magical ballads, only one can win. So perhaps Salvador overshadowed them, I guess, cast a shadow on the Blackbird. Yeah, which is unfortunate because it's such a strong song. I think if it had come much later and had been, if there had been greater distance with Salvador, they would have stood out more and that Blackbird would have flown to the sky. Alas. I saw them at the airport on the way out and they looked so sad. It broke my heart. And finally, our readers' most loved non-qualifier from Eurovision, it goes to Iceland 2016, Greta Salome, Hear Them Calling. Now look, I was having dreams before Eurovision that this could potentially win. It was so emotional, so powerful, kind of folksy, but then also pop. In Iceland, I think the visuals were just on point. They looked so amazing. You didn't see the audience, you just saw Greta and the stage and, you know, the hands and the people, the kind of figures haunting her. Then at Eurovision, I think maybe the visuals weren't as good because we saw the audience and it took us out of that other world. And like, once you know there's an audience, you're like, okay, I'm not in some alternate universe. I'm in Stockholm in an arena. However, she still deserved to qualify and she still deserved to do well. She was on point. She hit her cues. She looked great. She sounded great. But yeah, it didn't pan out. This is one of those great mysteries. We were watching in the press room and we were all so upset that she did not advance. I mean, I'm still torn up about it. Yeah, she's got a unique blend of gifts, you know, playing the violin, singing. She made the final with Yonsei with a good song, you know, in Baku, but this was superior. Hear them calling it superior, and it didn't make it. In any case, those are the results of the poll on the WeWe Blogs website. You can also look in the description to see the official results of the Eurovision Again vote. What was your favorite? Which songs are you still upset about? Which songs are you still listening to? I guess, what's the greatest crime in the history of non-qualifiers at Eurovision? Let us know down below. All right, we'll see you later. Bye!